you've worked in many business sectors over the years. What would you say have been your favourite?
My favourite has to be working on Todd's Leap here and off-road diving. That has to be my favourite,
yeah.
Because it involves me what I do for a sport, and I'm now doing it for a living. So
excellent.
If you love what you do, it ain't work, is it?
That's it, yeah. And this other business, that's your...
Well, we have a shelving and racking business. We provide warehouse fitting all over the country, all over the UK, mainly in the second hand market. We rent racking, we buy and sell racking,
yeah.
And we fit out all sorts of wares. We don't go through the front door of shops, we go through the back door,
yeah.
So we do stores. That's what we do.
If we describe you as a bit of an action man, what sport and hobbies would you say the most difficult, and how did you overcome those difficulties?
The most difficult is probably when I was playing judo. It's probably the toughest to do, but my favourite would have to be off-road racing, and the culmination of that was winning the Irish Championship in 2005-06 in my Suzuki. But that would be the favourite of the whole lot.
That would have been the career highlight then.
Oh, around. Absolutely! No,
that was
no,
the top.
There was nothing to touch that. But it was we were working with a Suzuki Jimny, and we had a Cosworth powered, and it was a fantastic machine.
What,
it's still
what
racing.
Oh, 05
and 06.
Yeah. And then you retired after that.
Well, I retired due to a medical condition. I detached both retina and a jump, and that was the racing career temporarily parked. So we haven't gone back yet. Yeah.
So since Finn and Todd's Leap has obviously gone from leaps to bounds, so the 4x4, that was a big major new direction.
We started Todd's Leap in 1989 when off-road driving wasn't a popular sport per se. It was very elite. There was a bit of racing going on and so on, but we brought it to the masses here, and we're probably the most successful company in the UK at doing that.
In the whole of the UK, yeah.
Aye, absolutely.
Yeah.
We have a fleet at the minute of over 100 vehicles, and we have over 80 instructors working with that fleet. So we have our name on the map as far as 4x4 driving and
And you're a big
fun
employer in the area as well.
Good, yesterday we have over 80 employees here.
Yeah.
But the thing is that we've taken 4x4 driving and shown people what they really can do.
Yeah.
And not just for fun, but we're of a serious side as well. We have a training company. We're RASPA and RTATB and Atlanta accredited.
Safety's a big thing as well.
Safety's number one priority at Todd's Leap. Yeah, you have. If you don't run a safe business, you'll not have any business.
Yeah. So what's your favourite vehicle of all time? What would you say?
Oh, favourite vehicle of all time? Well, it has to be, at the minute, it has to be the new Range Rover.
Right.
You know, I've had all the Land Rover marks and the new Range Rover, I'm saving up. You know, I'm saving up, that's
so,
all I say.
Back to the main business, Paddy. Do you have a personalised registration number yourself then?
I have a few. The one that I really want is Ben 10H with Benny O'Hanlon.
We'll do our best to source that.
That one wasn't actually given out, but the closest I got was the one I have on here, was the B3 NOH, Ben O'H. So that's the best I have at the minute. You know, but I have several other ones on staff cars and so on, but no real, real good ones, you know.
Right. And what do you say? You've obviously further developments here. Any big new ideas coming up, or?
Well, we have a few. I'll take you around the workshop and see. It's top secret at the minute because we're waiting on patents coming through. But we have a new activity in the oven. It'll be launched this year. We're also currently building a dual zip line, which will be the first and definitely the first in Ireland over the distance. And we're doing tandem zip lining, which is going to be a very, very interesting concept, you know.
Yeah.
So we're on that for this season, but we have a new product that we hope to have launched before the end of the season as well. So we're,
I think, Benny, to finish off, the first time we met was maybe 10 years ago in Birmingham Airport, and we're sitting there on an EasyJet flight waiting to take off about 8 o'clock. No information. I think we were two major spokesmen. We challenged EasyJet. So how would you say, what sort of personal attributes would you say you'd need for that situation?
Well, it's like any business, it's all about communication. And that particular thing, when we analyse what was going on, it was misinformation.
Lack of information was
the cause of the problems. And that's the same in any business.
Yeah.
Business flows, communication flows, and business flows with it.
Yeah,
you know?
I think that's very important. Personal information, you know, keeping the customer happy.
Keep the customer informed.
Yeah, keep the customer informed.
Yeah, and then you can worry about keeping them happy, but if they're not informed, they'll definitely not be happy.
It's like we got safely back eventually. We got a free meal for the passengers.
And a round of applause.
That's great, Benny. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.